Alright, hello everyone, and welcome back to New Vegas Bounties, where today we are right we left off in the last episode here inside of Randall and Associates and about to go and do our next bounty mission, which I'm quite intrigued for today, because a lot of the missions we have done so far, of course, have been fairly just, you know, generic bounty hunting. You have information on person, go kill person. But we did, of course, have a few little rays of sunshine with that whole continuing intrigue with the judge. And then last episode with that cannibal hiding in a bunker, or well, shelter at the very least, who did knock us out. So we're starting to get some more interesting things, and I'm hoping that continues and becomes, well, frankly, more interesting. So let's go have a little chat with Randall here.
I've got a lucrative bounty. Ooh. If you're ready for work.
I'm always up for a more lucrative bounty, but oh, let's, yeah, talk to you a bit more first. Earlier described ghouls as zombies. You know, that's offensive, right?
That's not offensive. Someone putting a 12-gauge up your ass and pulling the trigger, now that's offensive.
Well, no, that'd just be murder.
I once saw a zombie do that to one of my friends, so it left a strong impression.
Don't
get me wrong. I've met some square ghouls like Doc Friday and... Well, let me think. I'm sure there are others. I'll get back to that. Anyway, the incident I'm referencing happened over 10 years ago.
Okay.
Me and my partner, James, were tracking a bounty in New Mexico. We were unfamiliar with the territory, and eventually some ghouls got the jump on us. I was wounded, and James was green, so it went bad. They were a collection of ghoul fanatics from some reservation, and they took us captive after the firefight. Their leader was a ghoul named Phillips. Ray Phillips, that's it. I think he had relatives back east.
Right.
Anyway, old Ray took special pride in making us smooth skins suffer. He said he would use the five pains method on us.
The what now?
He started with James, cutting off his nose, his hand, and then a foot. Ray was going to cut him in half, but James called him a zombie cunt. Ray didn't appreciate the label, so he responded by shoving his shotgun into James and pulling the trigger. Now, how I got away is an interesting story since, God damn it, look at the time.
No!
I've got to finish this typing. And you've got me distracted.
But I want to hear the interesting
story.
Are
you ready to work or not?
Damn it, Randall. Also, I mean, sure, that was an awful thing, but we hear about stuff like that being perpetrated all the time by all sorts of groups in the wastelands. So, what's the difference between those ghouls and, like, the freaking fiends? Yeah, Randall, buddy, that's, All right, well, yes, let's do the lucrative job. Let's hope it's actually lucrative for a change.
Good. This next contract has some significant risks, but a hefty payday to match it.
Okay.
Your target is a gunslinger known simply as Jack.
Got it.
Our client hasn't given us much to work with, but it doesn't matter. Jack used to be the chief gunman for Heck Gunderson and managed the muscle in Gunderson's operations.
All right.
When I said he managed the muscle, I mean he pretty much was the muscle. Jack intimidated countless landowners into selling their property. Along the way, Jack managed to rack up a significant body count. Over the years, he became more and more ruthless. Recently, Jack shot up a farmer and his wife, so Mr. Gunderson quickly cut all ties with his pistolero.
Okay.
Now, Jack is just another gun for hire.
And he needs to be taken
down.
Without
Gunderson to protect him, though, Jack is fair game. He's made plenty of enemies, and they all want to see him dead. Last I heard, he had drifted into Good Springs.
Oh no, not Good Springs.
Get work with the locals. Jack is as fast as they come, so be ready, kid. Good luck.
Got it. We'll take care of it. Okay. Oh no, I need to go protect Good Springs. They've been good to me there. All right, so let's see. What do we got for the note this time? Oh yeah, the 2 Jane letter. Forgot about that from last time around. Good one. All right, so we've got Jack, Caucasian, independent, location Good Springs. Jack used to be the gunman for Heck Gunderson, but after murdering an unarmed farmer and his wife, Jack has been let go by the cattle baron. Heck is apparently making every effort to distance himself from the psychopathic pistolero. Jack is unprotected, alone, and he's threatening to spill the beans on the less than savory aspect of X operation. Yeah, that's just not a smart move, man. A, well-off, rich, Brahmin Baron. You don't want to piss them off. They're definitely going to send people out to kill you. But okay, word has it that he's drifted into Good Springs looking for work as a hired gun. He is very, very quick with the pistol, perhaps as fast as Doc Friday. Ooh, okay. You know, I really do hope we get to meet him at some point in this. We've heard about him several times now. I'd advise you shoot first and talk later. Good luck. Oh, well, we're definitely going to go talk to him. Oh, unless he's one of the many bounties we've encountered so far who just shoot first. I'll be intrigued to see. Granted, if he's in Good Springs looking for work, I wonder if maybe we can trick him into something. I don't know, but okay, no enemies around, no red on the compass. We should be good to fast travel. And why did I go there? Nope, world map. Excellent. And up to Good Springs. Nice. Yeah, I'm worried he is just going to start shooting, and currently I believe I have my grenade launcher equipped, so I'd have to switch weapons before we, you know, start firing at him, just in case, so we don't accidentally hit any people here in Good Springs. Oh, God! It appears that Jack is waiting for you. You should approach with caution. Wait, where? I shouldn't have fast-traveled. Oh, there he is. Okay, he's getting close. Yeah, grenade launcher is a bad plan. Just good old plasma defender. God, I love that thing. Well, maybe we should use something a bit more powerful on him, though. Oh, yeah, we got that recently, didn't we? Yeah, plasma defender. There we go. Could probably use a repair on that, too. We did loot a weapon repair kit recently, so let's use one of those. There we go, and how you looking now? Magnificent. Okay, hi, Jack. How's it going, buddy? Gun out. You know, maybe let's just keep it down. Keep it down. Quick draw. Maybe if we have the gun out, he'll be pissed.
Courier turned bounty hunter.
Yo.
I hear you're making quite a mark in the Mojave. I applaud you.
Why, thank
you. Of
course,
I assume you're here for the bounty.
How do you know me, though?
Old man Gunderson's going soft, I'm afraid. He'd have nothing if it weren't for me and this pistol.
You know, that's fair.
And as for you, I think Randall and associates are trash.
Well, that's just rude.
In fact, every bounty hunter they've sent after me has been trash. And that pretty much makes you trash as well.
Well, time for you to die. Also, man, those eyebrows. How do you know who I am, though? I mean, it's not like my picture is floating around the world. Wow, we're just going straight with both insults. I'll just go with what has he lied about? I mean, again, calling us trash, I guess. But who knows? You're a filthy liar, though.
Prove it.
Okay. And headshot. Oh, God, I only get 3 shots on him. But there we go. 1, 2, 3, and... Oh, boy. All right. He's taking some cover there. You know what? There's no one around. Everyone's inside. It's nighttime. There we go. And that was a little too far away. There we are. Lovely, lovely, lovely. When we're a bit too close, we get a lot of vibrations. Okay, good. He's dead. Reload. And what does he got there? Okay, some good ammo. Jack's outfit. I mean, it's unique, so I'm going to take it, clearly. A Desperado cowboy hat? Ooh. Shane's Bane. I'm going to be over-encumbered if I take all of this. I'm going to be over-encumbered, but we're taking it! I really need to go somewhere and drop this stuff off. Oh, it's been so long since we played this character. Do I have a home anywhere? I don't remember. I mean, we've done a lot of things for a number of different factions. Surely we should have one somewhere by now, right? I don't know. I should look into that. Oh, boy. All right, well, let's just get rid of some 8-item things. I gotta heal myself anyways. Yeah, just some good sunset sarsaparilla. There we go. Now we're no longer over-encumbered. Sweet! Why did I exit out? I needed to go to the world map and back down here. You know, I don't care how fast of a gunslinger he is. I've got a freaking grenade launcher. Pistol versus grenade launcher. I think the grenade launcher's gonna win. Good times. Boy, should have done VATS with those shots, though. It's always such a pain when you're close enough that it vibrates the screen, and then you set off another shot that goes too far, too close. Yo, Rando!
Did you kill Jack yet?
Oh, yeah, he's super dead.
I'm a little surprised to see you unscathed. Good work.
That wasn't very lucrative. We've gotten 500 caps before! Come on, Randall! Oh.
I'll see you later.
Bye-bye. I mean, I'm going to talk to you immediately here, because I need another one. I was hoping for a little bit more on that one, but at least we didn't get to talk to our person for a change.
I've got a contract on a crazy fiend.
Ooh, do you
know? Another job?
I most certainly am.
All right, here's the story. The Westside Militia has lost some personnel to a marauding fiend ringleader named Kurt Catel.
Got it.
He and his crew have been ambushing patrols and periodically taking captives.
Oh, no.
Reports indicate his favorite torture is gnawing on the intestines of living captives.
The hell?
Needless to say, he's a sick fuck.
Uh-huh.
Bag this asshole and head back, okay? Good luck.
Okay, and Rand, I'm gonna bring up the thing with the you and ghouls from earlier. Dude gnaws on people's still living entrails. Yeah, messed up world out there in the Mojave, bro. Alright, so what's the note on this one? So we're heading back up this way, and I'm actually quite pleased that we'll be heading over here, considering this character has done a lot of work over in this area before, helping out the Westside folk, because that's where the Powder Militia is based. So yeah, good. It'll be good to help them out some more. Where would be a good place to spawn in? Honestly, probably the El Rey Motel. Yeah. But first... What's our bounty thing here? Caucasian question mark. Okay. Fiend camp near the Sunset Sarsaparilla headquarters. All right. Kirk Cattle? No. Leads a band of fiends who've been terrorizing the Westside Militia. He personally oversees the torture and mutilation of captives and is reputed to gnaw on the intestines of living victims after disemboweling them. Like most fiends, he's a drug-addled maniac who will shoot on sight, so don't take any chances. Got it. Well, outside we go, and then we'll travel to the El Rey Motel. Nice. Alright, been a long time since we've been over this part of the world, and despite all the work we did with the Westside Militia over here, I really don't have this section filled out, do I? Alright. Good times. Well, so it'll take a little bit longer to get over to him, so it means probably only 2 bounties today. Last episode was quite the oddity with 3, but they all did go pretty quick except for that last one. Still was my favorite, though. That was great. Alright, so he is over there, but we gotta cross the bridge over here. Oh, we got more enemies here. Hello. Die, fiend. Oh, no, at least go for the higher chance. Wow, we missed him super hard there, that last shot. Oh, God, I almost immediately fired. That would have been bad, right as he got in front of me. Okay, I'll take those and that. Lovely. Reload the grenade launcher. God, I actually need to get a some repairs on that one, too. Yeah, that's good. Alright. Got a fair amount of grenades for it, so I'm not going to worry too much on them. Usually there's more fiends over here. Oh, well. Not my problem. It's one less thing I gotta worry about. Okay, so let's continue over this way. Head for that marker. Let's avoid full-on fiend country. So stick to the peripheries here. Alright, looks like it's a Poseidon gas station here that we'll be hitting first. That'll be the waypoint we're looking for. That'll be good for the future, too, just in case we come over this way for any other things. And I guess this wasn't a waypoint. It was just so close to the Sunset Sarsaparilla place that I thought it was. All right, fair enough. Though, no, all right, I was trying to look at the map of how that one was moving down there. So never mind, I thought it would take a little bit longer to get over here. This guy might be pretty easy to kill and easy to get back. So maybe another third. Ah, oh, jeez. Oh, yeah, we actually have the ability to get to them quicker. It's, doesn't take long, does it? Oh, he's over on the other side. Crap. Okay. You know what? He's, yeah, it'd probably be good to take him out with a a Gauss rifle, but we do not have a good... Oh, yeah, he's got other fiend friends over there. We do not have a good line of sight for that, but let's take a look. Let's take a look. I mean, we can at least draw him out by going after his fiend friends. Oh, yeah. Oh, he flipped good. And the other guy didn't even care. Oh, he finally cared. Oh, was that him? Because he took a shot right to the face. Oh, boy. Oh, nope. That's probably him in the fancier armor. Okay. Nope, that was a mess. Oh, that one's coming. Well, he's down. And you know what? There we are. Oh, and hip. And hip. Oh, you've got a bit close. There we go. That one's, nope, not dead yet. There we go. All right. Oh, God. Oh, never mind. That's a flamer. I was really worried that he was going to start attacking me with a Gatling gun of some form. But no, we're good. There we go. He's dead. Was that him? Or did we get him earlier? His body seems to be over there. Okay, so that was not Kurt. Wow, I would have thought it would be with that, what we saw. All right, where are the other corpses? Reload. Yeah, I would have thought it was you. You were just a normal fiend. Huh. Oh, this one was Kurt. Okay. All right. Fair enough. Can I use that to fix my combat armor? No, you can't, can you? You gotta have combat armor for it. Oh, I really need to go somewhere to get my stuff repaired. Where was the body that flipped over here? There it is. I'll take those. All right, and back we go. Yeah, some of these have been going real quick. Jeez. Still no idea how many of these there actually are, so don't know when we're going to run out of things. Any red? Nope, we're good. Then we go. All right, Randall. Got him.
Did you take care of Kurt?
Oh, yeah. You got exploded.
Good work. You're bringing us a lot of business, so here's a bonus.
That was a good one. Aw, sweet. A bonus on that one? That was the best money we made so far.
I'll see you later.
All right, okay. Can you see me now?
The NCR needs help tracking down a defector. You ready to work?
I am.
Good. Here's the story. Chuck Bowdry, a senior NCR ranger, recently defected to Caesar's Legion.
Oh.
Before jumping ship, he killed two fellow rangers while on patrol.
How dare he?
Our client wants this guy terminated with extreme prejudice.
Understandable.
We don't have many leads, but he's said to be on the run up north. I happen to know that several rangers in Bowdry's old troop used to crash at Field Shack close to Nellis.
Okay.
Try there. Good luck.
How do you have people that know that stuff? Okay, to the thing. All right, what do we got on this? So he's Caucasian, now with Caesar's Legion, recently defected from NCR, location unknown-ish. Our client, the NCR, naturally reports that Captain Chuck of Boundary recently defected to Caesar's Legion, but only after killing two fellow rangers while on patrol. The NCR has assigned the rangers to Boundary's unit in hopes of monitoring his activities, as there was some suspicion of collusion with the Legion. Unfortunately for the Rangers, Bowdry sniffed out their true motives and decided to jump ship in murderous fashion. He's got all kinds of dirt on the NCR, so they want him tagged and bagged. He's rumored to be making his way east in the hopes of crossing into Legion territory. He is a sneaky bastard, so watch yourself. Got it. Alright, I have a feeling, and I'm worried that maybe the shack isn't going to be the right place, and it's going to be a bit longer of a one, like with having to go find the stuff last time. Oh, hey, back to the mole rat ranch, where maybe people may or may not be shooting at things that I'm not sure of why they were shooting at. That was weird the other day. Oh, boy. You all good? Whoa. They did it again? Oh, it was the enraged Brahmin. Those are still spawning? Didn't we take care of that ages ago in another... stuff and other things? I don't know. All right, well, this way we go. Over that way. All right, looks like we will pass a waypoint that we can grab on our way to it, which is always good. Again, for future map needs, since I still don't have this particular save files map, properly explored. Did I just hear the enemy music? Nope, never mind. I'm hearing things. Alright, there's the shack. We're going inside. I probably shouldn't have a grenade launcher. And back to the plasma defender. A lovely little pistol. Alright. Let's check this out. Looks like the shack is the place to be. There we go. Field shack. What do we got? You find the shack empty and devoid of clues. You should continue your search for Chuck elsewhere. Dang it. I kind of figured. So this wants me to leave? Yeah, but where? I have a feeling I'm going to exit the house and, oh, that was a star bottle cap. Crap. Did I ever do that in the save file? Am I going to be approached by that one guy now at some point? I don't know. You know, I could look in my inventory and find out, but let's loot all these things first. I have a feeling that guy is going to try and kill us on our way out. So he's probably staking the place out. Oh, hi!
You're dumber than you look, kid.
Uh-huh, he's
really
got friends.
You expect to get the drop on a seasoned ranger?
Well, I mean, you never know.
Either way, I'm not here to talk. Close your eyes, kid. I'll make it quick.
Not happening. And you're real close, too, so you're dead. He's got friends, which is unfortunate, but looks like he's going to die and the others have knives. Ooh, boy. All right, back it up, back it up, back it up. And that's going to be me. Ha, you're dead and your friends can't get to me. Excellent. He's a runner. He's a runner. Legionary assassin, huh? No. I think they're trying to run away because they can't get to me, so their pathing is trying to figure it. He picked up a gun! Okay, you've got to die now. You've got to die now. There we go. Die from Antarius! And where'd the other guy go? Oh, there he is. Hi! And that just body shots. Dang, didn't get him. Well, let's finish him off. Beautiful. All right. Get some of their ears, of course, for the future. Wonderful. And... Oh, he's got a legionnaire too, huh? That makes sense. Chuck's finger. Yeah, nothing else of value. All right, nice. Got it. Let's roll. Okay, God, that one didn't take quick either. His friends weren't very up to the task now, were they? Let's just, you know, use more of our Sunset Sarsaparilla for healing and get rid of some of our extra weight. And yeah, back to turning this one, and that'll be it for this episode. I mean, we're still a little bit shy of the usual time, but yeah, if we did a fourth, that definitely wouldn't pan out. Oh, we got red! They're back! Hello! And no, those didn't work very well at range. Okay. Dig out the legs. Die, ghoul! Get him. Next to the other one. The one that we killed a few episodes back. Nice. They're just going to end up as a pile of ghoul corpses there, isn't there? Oh, well, works for me. Turn in the finger.
Hey,
hello,
there.
Randall.
Is Chuck dead?
He very much is, as well as two other legionnaires.
Good. I must admit, I harbor an acute loathing for traitors of any sort. So here's a bonus on me.
Sweet. Man, we're starting to finally get some decent pay out of these things.
See you later.
Bye, Randall. All right. Yeah, it's pretty happy that... Oh, hey, the ghoul corpse finally disappeared. Wonderful. But yeah, I'm finally happy we're getting some better money out of this. The other previous bounties have been pretty low. But that's going to be a good place for us to end on this one. In the next episode, we'll continue on with these bounties, see where they take us from there. But until that time, thank you for watching. As always, we'll have a good one.